I initially got involved in the design a toilet project by being approached from the Innovation Centre.
When you go out of school, that's the first opportunity to be able to be involved in a real project straight away.
I was asked would I go along to Central St Martins to brief the postgrads on the workings of a toilet.
Insider information, which you kind of have to get from the people actually working with toilets.
It's a really difficult exercise actually, and a really interesting one.
Dyno doing this because they are at the forefront of innovation.
It's basically called the energy producing toilet, and the idea is to try to step away from a energy depleting method of sanitation and actually utilise the biogases that are produced to actually make the bathroom at least a self-sustaining environment. Human faeces, urine, are processed through this large top section. The gases are extracted, which basically biofuel is then used to power the bathroom and other appliances. The non-toxic waste is then fed through to the outside of the building, used to create an urban landscape. So it's used as a fertilizer.
This design tries to incorporate the whole bathroom suite into one piece of furniture, consisting of like a main unit, sink and a toilet. The main unit is connected to the shower. All the wastewater from the shower collects up in here and down through the floor. This water you can use to flush your toilet. Normal toilet flush is usually between 5 or 6 liters. So actually for a family, this could save you 50, 60 liters of clean water every day.
So it's called well-being toilets. The position we use today is not the proper one we should use. A squatting position helps us to get rid of all the waste in your body more effectively. The way you are sitting on this toilet is as on a normal toilet, and then be able to bring your knee on the top part, and that will bring you on the proper squatting position.
I think working in a group is really good because it allows you to hone on other people's skills. You obviously learn a lot from each of the other designers.
Having a constant conversations and getting feedback and harsh critique sometimes as well from your co-workers really helps you develop.
We was actually quite spoiled for choice when we first seen them. Came up with some really, really good ideas considering they've got no technical background at all in the plumbing industry. The next stage is to pick one from the three which were made into a prototype. It's going to be exhibited at Central St Martin's College. It's Dyno's 50th birthday this year, so to be involved in celebrating that, I'm really, really excited and I'm very proud to be part of it.
It has been an amazing experience to see that actually in such a mundane object you can do amazing things as well.